jump into the computer, and I'm going to take you through step by step just exactly how you use your Google Analytics and your now synced Search Console account to find your site's click-through rate. And then that way you can use your click-through rate to optimize your site and to make more money. Click-through rate, Google Analytics. Finding the formula really isn't that hard, but first, got to do something. Who doesn't rant and rave about the wealth of knowledge and insight they find in Google Analytics? Actually, a lot of people. This article, Click-Through Rate, Google Analytics, Finding the Formula, will clear up a lot of the fuzzy, not so easy to navigate areas of analytics and CTR and how to find your CTR, putting you on the path to understanding of how to bring in way, way, way more money in your site using the data. But first, let's look and see how some of the internet feels about Google's data tool. I would say the majority of the internet has no idea how to utilize Google's awesome analytic tool set. Let's change that for you specifically. On top of that, the ones who do have usually been around for a while, and not all, but many of them have consistently made very public complaints about why the tool is not all that great. Take Larry Kim, for instance, who I respect. He's wrote lots of things that have helped me. But Mr. Kim wrote about the analytics tool in his article, Hacking Your Way to 5 times Higher Organic Click-Through Rates, an article that he wrote for Moz back in 2016. In that article, Mr. Kim said this, for starters, it's ridiculously, and I quote, hard to tell what your organic click-through rate is for a keyword. Thanks, Google. And that's nothing new. Everybody says things like that on a regular basis, and it's understandable. But then Mr. Kim continued his rant. And he continues here saying, another challenge preventing CTR from being a bigger deal today is Google Analytics, which hasn't provided keywords to us for years. You can figure out the number of impressions and clicks for your top 1,000 pages. But the limited query data, 1% of the total, is a killer. It might be easy to see your CTR data, but it's hard to know whether what you can see is good or not. Excuse me. Having only 1% of the data of the total queries does suck. And I can see his point to some extent, albeit I can't get past the glaring fact that Google is a private for-profit business. If I was in Google's shoes, I would make the prudent business decision and stop releasing assets of that type of worth for free as well. Who wouldn't? Anyone could use that data to save themselves a lot of money. And in this case, it's a lot of money that I would, if I were strong arm of the alphabet, I would normally pocket if I decided to stop giving so much data away freely. So why keep giving it away if you're a private for-profit business? And we all know that most of Google's money comes from ads anyway. So why would you keep giving that away for free? It doesn't make any sense. And I'm not the Gooks themselves, but I still don't understand Mr. Kim's complaint. If you don't like how Google plays, then take your searches and go play with someone else. That's how I see it. But some get caught up in the luxuries that are no longer available, having ran their course a bit too early for their taste, proving that convenience is a cruel crutch. Boom, dependency sets in. And as soon as that happens, the crutch cracks and so crumbles the cripple. The same cripple who had no trouble walking until after resting for convenience on what was not a crutch at all, but a subtle snake. On the flip side, many users absolutely love Google Analytics. For me, it's a love-hate relationship, but we won't get into all that. We're already off course enough. So let's get back to the topic. All right, now we're going to jump right into the content, and we're going to show you just exactly how you can find your site's click-through rate. And for the very beginner, you can just keep reading, and I'll walk you through the entire process step by step. For the intermediate who already uses Google Search Console, you can skip to the subheading that reads Intermediates. I am the subheading with your targeted benefits below me. If you're more advanced and you already have your Search Console and Google Analytics accounts synced and set up and sharing data, but still can't seem to find the data on your click-through rate, then you can skip down to the subheading that reads Here's the final step. And then below, I'm going to show you the times. You've probably already seen them, but you'll see the times in the video that you can skip to be at the place that you need to be at if you're an intermediate or an advanced learner. All right, so let's get to look, listen, and learn. This is for the beginners again. All right, beginners, let's get into it. First of all, have you properly tagged the Google Analytics script into the head of your site's pages? If not, follow the steps below. And what you'll see is you'll see you go into Google Analytics and sign up, because obviously that's the first thing you need to do. If you haven't signed up for an analytics account, that's what you have to do first right off to start using. That's pretty obvious. It says it here. Obviously, if you do not have an account, you'll need to click on the sign up box, blah, blah, blah. And again, all these screenshots are from Google Analytics or the Search Console, and it's courtesy of Google. And then I just threw some boxes and steps in on my own. And the second step that you'll need to follow is choose what you'll be using Google Analytics on. Do you have a website or an app? I'm going to be teaching how to set this up, how to set up Google Analytics, the tracking method, for a website, not for a mobile app. Number three, you're going to name your Google Analytics account, whatever it is you feel like naming it. I would name it something that you're going to relate to whatever site you're using, something that makes sense. I don't understand when people don't make sense and they just have Google Analytics account one. That doesn't make sense to me, but if that's how you want to do it, go ahead. Personally, I think that you should do it in relation to what it is you're doing, in relation to your website. All right, number four, enter your website's name in the box there. Then your website's URL just below that. And you can change this if you see here, it says HTTP. If you've already set up your SSL, your socket's already good, then you can change this to HTTPS. If that's how your site reads when you go to your site, then definitely do that first. You don't want to just set up the Google Analytics account on something that's not going to get any traffic. You understand what I'm saying? All right. And that's what this all says here. Then select your industry and your time zone, whatever industry that is. I wouldn't be too worried about that. You can always edit this, okay? If you're not 100% on what your industry is, you can always come back and edit that. And then your reporting time zone. I'm Pacific time, so I would put Pacific time. All right, and then the next, you're gonna see all this junk here. It's not junk, you should read through all that. You should learn all that. You can click on all these links when you're doing it on your own, and I would do that. After you're going through the, look at that, I spelled going without a G, like I'm from the South or something. After going through the privacy policy, you've made it to step five, where you get your tracking ID. Click on that, and once you get it, it'll say just like this, UA, and then it'll be a bunch of numbers here. That's your site's tracking ID. Obviously, I scratched mine out for good measure, because I don't want anybody to see mine. It's not something I want to share with people. And then the global site tag. This is the global site tag tracking code for this property. Copy and paste this code into the head of every web page you want to track. If you already have a global site tag on your page, the config line from the snippet below to your existing here it is. You just highlight all this. Sorry, you highlight all that right there, and you change out this. Make sure that it has your actual tracking number, your actual tracking ID right here. Sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it'll be like a generic right there. Make sure that your actual tracking ID is there, and boom. You're done with your Google Analytics. It's all set up. All right, now that you have your Google Analytics set up, again, and just to go over this real quickly, because I think I kind of left it off in a way that's might have been confusing. When you put this code, when you copy and paste it into the head of your website, into every page that you want to track, make sure that your tracking code is here. If it's not here when you see this screen come up, if it's not there, don't worry about it. Just make sure that that tracking ID is in the code that you copy, the script, the JavaScript that you copy and paste into your head. Just make sure that if you have that, then you're all good to go. All right. Now let's move over to the next step. So next, how to set up your site's webmaster tools the right way. That's what we're going to be going into next. Now that you have your Google Analytics account all set up, it's time for the second half of the formula, the Search Console. Search Console include some of my favorite data. And after your site is set up with the proper webmaster tools, and webmaster tools and search are the same thing. Google uses both terms, and so I use both terms just so that you're not confused at all. And if you did get confused, sorry, because as I'm reading it, it seems kind of confusing. But they're the same thing. Search Console, Webmaster Tools, same data, same tool. I'm sure you'll find the console to be very rewarding and helpful. And just in case you've never set up a property with the Search Console, just look below to see how. Welcome to Search Console. This is what you'll see when you get into the Search Console. Just search for Search Console in Google, or you can search for Webmaster Tools, and this is where you'll end up being at. And this screenshot's obviously courtesy of Google. Just want to say that real quickly. But it'll look something like this. Welcome to Search Console, blah, blah, blah. What you need to do is you need to add a property. That's the very first thing. You're adding a website. Make sure that you put the full URL verbatim to how you would find it if you were visiting the site normally. So if you were going to the site, that's exactly what you want to be here as well. All right. Next, in the Search Console, you're going to verify that that site is your own site. The recommended method is the HTML file upload. And all you have to do is simply follow the instructions below. You download the HTML verification file, and it'll be right there. And then you upload that same file to whatever website, whatever property you just added, okay? And then you confirm a successful upload by visiting, seeing that it's there. Go to the link that'll be there. It'll be in the same place as it is on this page, on your page. All right, you visit it in the browser and you make sure that it's there. And then you go to number four, the step four, and that is click verify below. All right, don't remove the HTML file if you want to stay verified even after the verification succeeds. So that needs to stay there. That file needs to stay uploaded to your site. Not hard, not difficult, it's very easy, okay? All you have to do is go through the CAPTCHA and click verify after that, and you're done. All right, if you need further walkthrough, say something in the comments and I'll make a video, because some people do mess this up, but it really, it's very easy. If you know how to upload files onto your website, which isn't hard at all, you should know how to do that, then you'll be able to do this very easily. Shouldn't be a problem. Don't go the alternate methods, honestly. If you don't know how to upload a file onto your site, you need to reconsider making a website. And I'm not trying to be a jackass or anything, but fuck. Seriously. All right. Wow, we're almost finished. This hasn't been so bad, actually. And now the beginners are all caught up with the intermediates. Pretty much everyone should be on the same playing field now. But just to make sure, though, really quickly, if you have made it this far in the article, you should have a web property that has a Google Analytics account, and that property should have a Search Console or Webmaster Tools, whatever you want to call it, account as well. Property that's verified by Google. If that's not the case for you, then you need to go back and review the article and see whether you need the Search Console instructions again or the analytics sign up one more time. All right, and for the intermediates, here we finally are. And this is the subheading that you've been waiting for. Bottom line, we're almost finished. We're gonna go over how to link your Search Console and your Google Analytics account now. That's the next thing in line, all right? And for the intermediates that already have the Search Console and the Google Analytics account, this is perfect for you. Let's go through how to link the properties data. To sync the two properties through Google Analytics, it's the easiest way. I would do it through this, okay? This is how I would do it, all right? Just go through this step right here. You go to your Google Analytics account, whatever that is, right? And on the left here, where it says acquisition, you're going to scroll to that tab and you're going to click on it. Then click the tab below it, which will say Search Console. All right. Now, if your Search Console property and your analytics account are not synced, the data sharing isn't going on, then this is what will come up. This report requires Search Console integration to be enabled. Set up Search Console data sharing will be the button right there. All you have to do is simply click that. All right, and then follow the instructions. It's so simple. So simple. I'm not even going to go through it further than that. All right. And then for the people that already understand, the experts, the ones that are past this already, you already have your Search Console and your Google Analytics account already linked up, then this part is for you. This is the final step. We finally made it here. Go to your Google Analytics account, okay? The property that you want to look at is the one you just linked up and all that, if you're a beginner or intermediate. And if you're an expert, you already know what you're doing. What you're going to do now to find that data is you're going to come over to your navigation bar over here on the left, the one that's for your specific property. We're going to be looking at my specific property, the City of Phoenix Jobs We're Hiring. That's a site that's less than 2 months old for me now. And it's had a rough go at it at first, but it's getting there. It's getting there. It's a work in progress. We're going to look over some of that. So yeah, don't judge my data. All right. Yeah, there's not very much going on here. I'm sorry. I'm still working on this one, but don't give me a hard time about it. All right. So what you're going to do next is you're going to come down, not home or customization, not real time, not audience. What you're going to do is you're going to come to acquisition. All right. You click on acquisition and you're going to scroll down to the Search Console. Okay. It's going to say it right like that. It's really easy to find. I'm going to click it. Okay. And what will come down, a drop down will come, and it'll be for your landing pages, your countries, devices, and your queries, much like you see in the Search Console, right? And you're going to come down and click queries if you'd like, or click whatever you'd like, but we're going to look at queries for example's sake. Click on queries and your data should come up right to the right. Now, my site has had 934 impressions so far, and the clicks, there's been 39 clicks. It doesn't give me the data, the actual name on this one. Thank you, Google. But the CTR overall is 4.18, which isn't great, not by any means. But like I said, I've been working on this site and still continue to work on this site, and I'm going to continue to work on this site. So don't judge me yet. Give me some time to get all caught up here. But the CTR so far is 4.18, but this is where you'll see it on your site. All right. Thank you, everybody, for sticking with all this. I know it's been a longer one, but thank you for sticking with me and checking out what I have to show you about your click-through rate. And we're just getting further along now. And click-through rate mobile, ctr.mobi, is a brand new site too. So please stick with it. It's got a lot of work to go through. And I'm working on it. It's about a month old now. And it's going to be better. So stick around and see what you can learn there. And again, thanks for watching the video with me and reading the article. Please subscribe and like the video if you would, and share it with your friends. And go to ctr.mobi and check out the site and like and subscribe there as well. All right. Thanks, everybody.